Subscribe and press the bell icon to never miss an update from First Post.
Hi guys, today on Family Matters, we have with us actress Kriti Sanon, along with her mother Geeta Sanon, and we're going to be talking about, well, family matters, growing up influences, love and laughter, and more. Kriti and Mrs. Sanon, welcome.
I'm actually very excited because it's her first ever interview.
Wow. Mrs. Sanon, what are your earliest memories of Kriti? Growing up, did you ever think that she's going to be an actress?
No, it never occurred to me. Actually, she was a very studious child and very calm and composed.
I'm still calm and composed.
Yeah, but I am a professor. My husband is a CA. So there was academic atmosphere at home.
In
the
house.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we never thought that she would take this line.
But I was always into dance. And
yeah, dancing, she was always interested in, but she was doing engineering.
Right.
Yeah, and she had been a bright child throughout. So it was just, you can say, destiny.
Kriti, how did you bring up the topic when you decided to tell your parents that you want to take up like a career in acting?
I think she already knew by the time I knew. Because
no, it was gradual.
Okay.
Yeah, it wasn't a jhatka.
It wasn't like one fine day.
It wasn't a jhatka, mummy, mujhe heroine banna. It wasn't that. I think I'm Bombay mein the. My dad was in Mumbai working.
Okay.
And we were here and randomly like some family members and all, you know, why aren't you modeling? You know, you've got such a great height and body, you should model and all. So that time I was like, okay, how do I start modeling?
Huh.
And then one of my mamas was here and he said that portfolio kara le, you know, and Dabboo Ratnani is a big photographer and all.
Yes.
And I had no idea who Dabboo Ratnani is. So I googled and I went on this contest.
Okay.
Which said that, you know, you give in your pictures. If you win this contest, you get a free portfolio by Dabboo Ratnani. Because I knew that he charges a bomb.
Right.
So that's how I clicked pictures randomly at home. I sent it. I won that contest. I got a free portfolio done by him. That was my first photo shoot. And then I started modeling. So I started doing ads and all.
Right.
So I think that's when I also realized that I could act. Whatever little bit was required, you know. Because earlier I was always into dance and never in like dramatics or anything.
Okay.
And then I think somewhere I started feeling a few directors told me.
Even for modeling, her father was not okay.
Okay.
He was apprehensive.
Yeah. She signed my contract.
Yeah. He went to Elite modeling
that
agency.
Time there was
he
an agency.
He refused to sign.
Yeah.
He kahan bachcho ko bhej rahe ho tum. I will not sign.
A lot of people actually
secure
feel
profession
very
hai
reluctant to do it.
Being a middle class person, you don't hear very positive good things. Also, you feel like, you know, there's a lot of pressure, it's not secure, it's not a 9-to-5 job.
Correct.
You know, then tha ki engineering kari hai, degree hai, kya karna hai.
Yeah, even my colleagues used to tell me, modeling to 10th pass bhi kar lete hain.
Oh, bahut short-lived
career hota hai. Itni bright ladki hai,
yeah.
Engineering ke baad, why are you sending her to that line?
Correct.
You know? So that way, but she was interested, so she kept doing some assignments side by side, like while she was studying. So it was clear in her mind also that she has to finish the degree.
I mean, I finished my BTEC and I had to also patao my parents by saying that I'll give a GMAT entrance exam because this,
yes,
you know, the safety and security thing.
Backup plans rehne chahiye.
Backup plan hona chahiye.
Yeah.
Plan B kya.
Yeah. That was the condition we had put.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
That you clear your GMAT with a good score.
What was your score?
It was 710.
Okay.
Yeah. It's not valid.
You crossed the limit.
I did. Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
Did you think jab isne matlab GMAT ka iska acha score aa gaya to did you think ki acha theek hai picture nahi ho then she'll, you know, sort of come back to it thoda try karke then she'll get back to a serious sort of professional studies?
No, actually no. She wanted to try into films and I always wanted that she should succeed in that.
Right.
But yeah, that was the backup thing.
Correct.
Like if suppose
if
nothing happens, yeah, then she can go and do MBA or something.
Yeah, like she's not like a college or school dropout.
I never thought. In my head, when I was giving the GMAT entrance exam also, I was like, ye main bas score lane ke liye kar rahi hu. I'm not going to pursue this.
But when you were modeling, you realized that you enjoy facing the camera.
Yeah,
and like
I liked being in front of the camera.
Yeah.
And I always liked being in front of the moving camera than like being on ramp. I never liked being on ramp so much. Okay. Like, I felt like, you know, it was just like...
She was not used to heels.
Okay. Yeah, and, which I'm still not. But I liked being in front of... Like, I was more excited when I was facing, you know, doing TV commercials. Yeah. And all. Yeah. Like, I was very excited then.
Because then you get to emote, it's pretty story, which is very different from ramp.
Yeah, but my first ramp walk, my first photo shoot, I have messed up, I have cried, I've come back home crying. And then she's told me, what you're going to do next? If you start crying like this, then how are you going to do anything?
Manage to do well in this.
Beta, slime mein bahut stress hai. Ye toh aaj bhi bolti hai.
I never believed in her because she was a shy child. And
I was very shy.
So she said, mama, confidence dheere dheere aa jata hai. So I think that was the best thing. Like, she had full belief in herself.
Yeah, I think you became certain that this is what you want to do, and then you do whatever it takes to kind of make it happen.
I mean, she's right. As a kid, I was someone
who... Yeah, she changed herself. I can see remarkable
change.
When
I met her the
change.
First time, I found her extremely confident. Like, she's not one of those girls who will go out of the way to sort of network with the media or anything like that. But when you meet her, she's very confident. I remember having a discussion on... who you wanted to be like, whose path you would like to follow.
And
Priyanka Chopra.
Yeah, I still say
that. You're talking about her. And she was very certain about it. Like, there was no confusion in her mind.
But I can also understand where she's coming from because as a kid, matlab
she
ghar
used
pe
to
koi,
hide behind my pallu when the guest, like,
guest
would
come.
She was like,
she's not those outgoing bachas ki, you
know,
be very friendly.
She would not go to birthday parties without maid or without me.
I needed company, like someone.
Someone to be there.
Also had stage fright. I also was very nervous, you know, to do anything. In my exams, like, I used to stop eating a night before and all, and she would just come give me juice because she knew I'm not going to eat.
Right.
So I was someone who used to take a lot of stress.
Okay.
And this line's the worst when you take a lot of stress because there's a lot of stress.
To stress about, yeah.
Also, I think I didn't know that I could act. She obviously didn't know that I could act.
Sure.
So for her also to see me suddenly come in front of media, in front of the camera, and, you know, be able to hold myself and be confident enough was a bit of a surprise.
When she said films, what was the first thing that struck you? Did you warn her against anything? Did you sort of tell her ki do's and don'ts, anything like that?
The one thing that she said, shaadi nahi hoti hai, bahut late karte hai shaadi.
Do you worry about her getting married?
It's a very wrong button, don't push this right now.
Yeah, I used to tell her by 23 you should be married.
What?
No.
She got married at 26.
I know.
In her time.
In her time.
In my time.
Why did you want to get married at 23?
Yeah, 23, mama, you were never so orthodox.
Because, no. I used to think I got married late. See, by the time Nupur was born, I must be in my 30s then. So, I used to think 23, 24 is the right age.
Okay.
It should not be that, okay, biologically my clock
is ticking,
is ticking,
I need to get married,
so I need to get married now and
fair
all.
Enough.
It shouldn't be a pressure, I feel. I feel it's a big decision and it's something that should come instinctively and gradually to you.
Yes.
And when your focus is work and it's, you know, this kind of work, you're ambitious in life, you want to do a lot, you want to achieve a lot. There's only one life, I feel.
True.
So I feel you should not let go of your dreams because you need to get married.
Absolutely.
Yeah. But I always feel like she's always been very supportive in that. So this was just a fun question, pop up sort of a thing that came. But it was never like, no, don't do this,
don't
because.
Do this. Yeah.
Yeah. And my answer was firstly that you got married at 26. When you can get married at 26, I can take my own sweet time.
Correct. I'm a different generation, so it can be a few years later. Yeah.
No, actually parents feel relaxed.
Yeah.
Once the
I think
children
psychologically
are,
they just feel more
married
assured
and settled.
Yeah, I don't think parents will relax even when the kids are married now.
Would you be okay if she had a live-in relationship? Because that's very common in the newer lifestyle.
Mama,
you have
a picture bhi kar liya. We have soch ke bol
raha hai.
No, actually, see, I have seen live-in relationships do not end in a marriage.
Okay.
Where have you seen firstly?
You look around yourself.
Yeah, okay.
This happens because after some time you get bored of each other and you have an option.
Right.
You know,
the exit route is open because there it's not formalized.
Yeah.
But why did you, I remember during Luka Chuppi, so I said it somewhere that, you know, I don't think my parents would be okay with it.
Right.
Cut to, I've come back and she's like, whenever I told you I'm not okay with it, I'm okay. Yeah, I'm cool. So that time she was being very cool. So next interview I've gone and said my mom is okay but dad's not.
I saw that.
So yes. Now the flip has happened again. Yeah.
Well, second thought.
See, so what if I have to go for a live-in? Say, I tell you, I'm going to live in for a year only because I want to see if this guy,
check him out.
I'm compatible or not. And then if I feel I'm compatible, I'll get married. Are you okay with that?
I'm putting
you
on the spot.
When the situation comes, then only I'll know.
Depending upon the guy.
Yeah, depending.
When she started out, did you like sort of go on the set or meet her producer or anyone, director from the team, to just get familiar with what's the setup? No.
I never wanted to go.
On my Telugu film set, in fact, she came once, but she never came on set. She kept sitting in the vanity because she had this phobia that if she comes on set, I'm going to get conscious.
Right.
And something will happen and I will do something wrong. So she didn't come on set. You remember actually, you were in the vanity?
See, that fear is inside me actually. I'm scared. So I want to keep myself away from that scene.
That's also very thoughtful.
Is Panipat the only one you've come on?
Yeah, that is the only one.
Dilwale also you never came, na?
No, never.
So actually very, very recently, just a few days back, I was shooting in Karjat for a song for Panipat.
Okay.
And that's when my mom, dad, my sister, all of them, they came and they saw like
a
little bit of...
Yeah, this was the first time I saw her shooting.
Okay.
Yeah, in fact, my first IFA awards was the first and probably the only time that they've come for an award function.
Okay.
Because it was my first IFA. I was getting a debut award and everything.
They
and
all forced
Singapore.
Me to go. I didn't want to go.
No.
It must have been nice, but once you went.
She has come till Singapore and she said, I'll stay in the hotel. I won't come for the award night. I said, why? She's like, because I have a feeling I'll come, you'll trip. I said, why do you have such feelings? And to be honest, I was about to trip. And I did not.
No, actually, now it doesn't happen. But initially, when she had to perform somewhere and we are sitting in Delhi in front of the TV. And as soon as her performance is announced, you know, my heart starts beating faster and I am scared.
Are you talking about live things?
Live things also, yeah.
Recorded?
When I know that she has performance.
Correct.
So, till the time after performance, she calls us and tells us that all went well.
Right, yeah.
I am like examination fever.
Even my sister, like sometimes when she's there, and if I'm on stage, she starts feeling really nervous and, you know, like nervous for me. So, I totally get
it. But I think it also comes from the fact that I had stage fright at one point, you know, and many times, like ramp shows and all, mein kai baar hota hai ki saadi atak gayi, shoot toot gaya, you know. Yeah. There are things that happen. And once twice it's happened with me and I've come back and told her.
Yeah.
Or, you know, when I have a thing that I think a lot about what has happened.
Okay.
So if like my exam has not gone well, if something's not happened right, I'll keep thinking about it. I'll come crib, I'll cry. Huh. I'm that cry baby sometimes.
Get very upset about it for a bit.
It is like in her childhood. When children have exam, mothers, all mothers, I think they are very anxiously waiting till the child comes back and tells ki achha ho gaya. So it is like that.
What are the do's and don'ts when they were growing up, Kriti and her sister? Were there any do's and don'ts in the household?
Of course there were. Like they were not supposed to party till
very
12
late.
Or and even in the evening, they used to go out for playing. So, they had to come back by 9 or 9:30.
And that was very strict. This coming back deadline.
Phone aa jata tha. It's like a... It's a regular thing. It's a ritual.
Late night movies with friends, not allowed. Night stays.
Not allowed?
Allowed. In some specific houses, like
कौन सी friend है जिसके
not all
friends
not all approved
मम्मी से बात कर रहा हूँ उसकी and all everything but actually staying in Delhi life is a little different. From probably here I would say safety wise so that way like my parents were like a little strict about the timings but I think by the time I came to college and all it was a little better like I've had like birthday parties and all where I've stayed late and then gone to a friend's house and stayed, which he like obviously knew about
in college.
In
see,
college.
In school, rules are different.
Sure, because when you're younger.
But you know, so, every rule that for me comes at a certain age. For my sister, used to come age minus 5, because she was 5 years younger. So she used to get all the privileges 5 years earlier than me.
Yeah, I think some things remain the same through generations. Yeah, yeah. Was there any sibling rivalry between her and Nupur growing up?
Not much, actually.
See, you don't remember then.
No, no. Actually,
you're talking about kids.
She used to
as kids.
Tease. Yeah, as kids.
As kids, mama, hum hathabai hoti thi meri aur meri behan ke beech mein.
No, that is not sibling rivalry.
Of course it is. Sibling rivalry only you're talking about.
No, no.
Sibling rivalry.
Yeah, I mean like in the sense you fight, you bicker, you say, okay, she's mama's favorite. No.
No, it's not like that. She used to tease her sometimes ki tujhe seedhiyon se utha ke laaye the
mark. You're adopted.
There was a market.
There's a market called Balco
Market. So, to Balco Market ki seedhiyon pe mili thi. And she was very small. She used to
believed it.
She used to cry.
She's believed it and then she used to cry. Then you picked me up from there. I'm not your child. You know? So I used to pull her leg like that.
Okay.
But that was like when she was very small.
Right.
But there's always a certain age where, you know, you whether your brother, sister, whatever, you fight like crazy. Both of us have gotten pitai from both of them also. Mom and dad. Right. Like, it's not like ladkiyan hai to nahi manne. No.
Full, they were
like,
tough with both of you.
Yeah, yeah. She's ran around me because of some test and all of that. And I've gotten caught in the balcony where I can't go anywhere else. And then after that, she's hit me also. So, all of that.
She was a very slow eater.
Okay.
Very.
Like, after coming from school, she used to take 2 hours in finishing one roti.
She'd sit with the meal in front of her and not finish.
Yeah, one roti she has to finish and she's watching TV and, you know, glued to the TV and slowly one bite will
morsel is going down.
That used to irritate me a lot. Phir main isko bahar kai baar nikal deti thi ki TV ke aage se.
Stop watching the TV and...
I've had incidents where after that also, after an hour, I've not had the dal that she'd given me because I hated yellow dal. She's come out and she's been furious enough to take the katori, throw it on the wall. That what is wrong with you and blah 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 blah. And then looked at the wall and ab saaf karo jaakar. So that has also happened. So I think I used to irritate her the most because of my eating habit.
Perils of growing up and bringing up children, I guess. But with the two of them, I'm sure there was a lot of male attention coming their way when they were growing up. How did you sort of ward that off? Because that's a big sort of problem area as far as parents are concerned, you know, because like the kids are growing up, they're excited about the attention and parents are worried, all of that. How did you manage that with, you know, in the age of internet and mobile phones?
I used to share my mobile phone with her when I was in school.
Didn't have a separate mobile phone till
in college. I didn't, obviously. Yeah,
till 12th. Okay. Didn't have it. I used to keep a watch on them, and I was very friendly, and they used to tell me things. So,
like with her, it's like with me especially, she would get to know if I have, like, say I have a crush on someone, or, you know, if I find someone attractive or whatever, and I'm talking to that person on the phone, I don't know, she'll be around, and the way I talk changes then, which she used to catch, and I could feel myself flushing because the heat coming out of my body because I didn't know what to do, and she used to be like, who are you talking to? Who's this person? I have not heard his name before.
Right.
Okay, which class is he in? Is there something else? You know? So she would catch on, I don't know how, always.
Yeah, mother's instincts, I guess.
Yeah.
With the two of them growing up, it always happens that one child gets a little more attention from outside or not, you know. How do you balance that out? Especially after she became an actress, model and actress, you know, and there's so much attention coming her way. How do you make the other person not feel like left out or lesser than the other sibling?
That is a very difficult thing to do because they are the same with
absolutely
both the kids.
Yeah.
Actually, it is the outsiders, relatives and friends or the people who are coming to your house.
Correct.
They somewhere show the difference.
Hmm.
So that sometimes pinches, but we can't control
absolutely
that. So that used to happen. Yeah.
But I
still
think,
happens, but yeah. I think Nupur has been very, you know, strong and supportive.
Right. Yeah, she's very understanding that way.
She's like, very understanding.
Like, even if she feels the difference from someone's side, she might like come home and crib about it and just show it that this was so weird.
Yeah.
But it's not going to affect her self-confidence, which is something I absolutely love about her, because I don't know how I would have reacted if I was in her place and, you know, it was the other way around.
Yes.
Also, I think my parents have never like
made you guys feel any different.
In fact, when Nupur was born, you know, when the kid is born, everybody's getting gifts for the newborn kid.
Yeah.
And I was like, what, 5 years old or something.
Right.
My mom actually told my Nanaji to also get gifts for me because I was feeling left out.
Hmm.
So I think they have their ways of sort of compensating.
Right.
Or trying to make, balance it out.
That's so actually thoughtful and sensitive of you. A lot of time parents don't think of these things because it's not any different in their minds. So they probably don't notice it.
Yeah.
But I think that's very important in kind of, you know, balancing out things between siblings.
Like even now, I feel like if there are certain relatives who are really close to her and she sees a difference in them, she would pick up the phone and say that, you know,
right,
you need to be more sensitive towards this thing and why are you behaving differently?
When she moved to Mumbai, what was it that you worried about the most? Ki, matlab iske link-ups, kuch project, say, you know, she's in it, not in it, or was it just ki khana khaya ki nahi?
This.
Yeah.
Yeah. Initially, I think this was the main thing, khana khaya ki nahi.
Yeah.
Baad mein, we've got a full-time maid like who cooks really well and they like her food.
Okay.
Khana khaya ki nahi, wo toh abhi bhi hota.
No, but it's more about food. I don't know why. Yeah. This topic never changes. I still get messages saying, juice pilo, ye kha lo, healthy khaya karo, pani piya karo. It's a constant on the family group.
Kriti, when you are reading a script,
yeah,
which may have like, you know, intimate scenes or something which is written in a particular way that your parents may not be comfortable, do you sort of have that in mind? Do you discuss it with them?
I do discuss it with them, but actually I think she's more bindas than sometimes I am. So there was a time when I was like, oh, I'm not very sure if I'm okay wearing a bikini and all. She's like, but kyun? To kya ho gaya?
Yeah.
Wo pehni hai to pehni hoti hai. Wo to fir swimming costume mein, swim pool mein jaoge to swimming costume mein jaoge. And I was like, mom, you need to chill. Yeah, but she's okay with it. Like I used to sometimes come home and just say that there was this fun scene today, and I'll just slip it in.
Right.
Like, you know, I'll just tell it.
Slip it into the conversation.
Yeah,
by
the conversation, by the way. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But I don't think she's ever
actually
had a problem.
We know that she can handle it.
Right.
And she knows it. She is the best judge.
And so also, I think they understand
not
that,
worried
it,
about that
movies are, you know, you there are certain things you can't be very, you know, inhibited and you know, you can't be so restrictive. It's a film and it's a character you're playing and there is a way how these things work and you know, unless you're doing it,
it should
to
not look
get
vulgar.
Attention.
Yes. It should not look vulgar on screen.
As
that
long
is
as
the
it's
only
a
concern.
Role that requires, I think it's fine.
Yeah.
It's just that because it's a movie, it gets a lot of unwarranted attention.
I think
of all
sometimes
kinds,
people publicize,
you know, good, bad,
it differently
ugly.
And sometimes they don't need to because
absolutely,
that's not what their focus is. So it depends from film to
like
film.
You'll have a film and then there'll be so much written about the kissing scene, you know, which will be seen in isolation.
I mean, in Hero Panti, we had a peck, okay, which came as exclusively something in the paper.
Right.
And I don't think she reacted also because I told her about it.
Yeah. I think it just needs a little conditioning to understand what
I think
it
my
actually
dad
means.
Might, I don't really know, you know, with my dad, it's like he might be getting awkward, but we tend to avoid this conversation.
Right.
So we don't discuss.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know. He must be talking to you. No, he doesn't discuss only this thing.
No.
I don't think I've seen a film like this sitting with my dad. I'm not.
Yeah.
I'll sit some other place.
That's all dads, na? Like this sex and intimacy and these are things which you don't discuss with them. They get really uncomfortable.
Yeah, yeah,
as do you.
Yeah.
And you're like, okay, let's just forget about it. Let's talk about other things.
Yeah.
There are plenty of things
true,
to talk about.
True, yeah.
What's the best thing about being the parent to a successful actor? And is there any downside?
Best thing is the limelight.
Right.
Like I'm giving this interview.
Absolutely.
And for the first time. And what is the negative thing?
Is there any downside to it?
There's too much of stress.
Mama, but that would have been in any profession that I would have been. You would have been equally stressed.
No.
When you say stress,
like
in what way?
See, everything changes from one film to another film. So it's not secure kind of profession.
Yeah, her always question is, what are you doing next?
Yeah, it's always like
now
sickle.
After this what? And I'm like, it's not a 9-to-5 job. I can have a break in the middle. It's fine if I'm not working for a month.
True.
You know, but for them, it's like, but why are you not working?
Yeah.
You know, so that comes in. And I think also a little bit, you know, there's a lot spoken about. Your life is a lot out there in
it's very public. Everything becomes
public. Which not all of it might be true.
Yes.
But to a normal janta, like my badi masi might call her up and say, ki, maine suna hai, ye hua hai, ye hai kya? So she has to answer all that.
Yeah.
Correct.
That is very irritating.
Very difficult to explain to people who don't understand also. Ye bhi hota hai.
Yeah.
Nahi, they have very weird questions sometimes.
like
a song of Luka, Chuppi came and my Masi called me and said, ki ye ladki ki awaaz achhi nahi hai. बदल नहीं सकते तो मेरे को बहुत गुस्सा आया कि व्हाट कैन आई डू कि लड़की की आवाज अच्छी नहीं है तो आई केप्ट द फोन बट आई वाज यू नो बॉइलिंग सो आफ्टर सम टाइम आई कॉल्ड हर
राइट
एंड सेड कि
बदल दी
वो ना बदलवा दिया मैंने तो बस
मैंने बदलवा
दिया शी सेड अच्छा बहुत अच्छा कि Like, they don't understand that these things are not in her hand.
But I think now she understands.
Yeah.
But I do realize that the relatives or friends and all, they don't ask me all these questions.
Correct.
All the calls go to her. You know, talking about things. If they've read something in the paper, they'll, you know, be questioning that I've heard she's doing this. But she knows it's a rumor now. She has to clear it to five people that it's a rumor.
Yeah.
So, yeah, those things.
Now, all of us obviously are hugely influenced by our mothers, and I'm sure there's a lot in you which is a legacy of your mom. So tell us a little bit about that part of you.
I think the fact that I'm very strong-headed comes from her. I think the fact that I have opinions on things and I voice my views, I don't keep them to myself.
Right.
It's a lot her.
Okay.
The fact that I am a feminist and I question things, whether it is rituals, whether it is... I think now my questioning might irritate her also because I've gone four steps ahead where I question everything. So, but it all sort of comes from her. I feel, you know, the being independent and doing what you want to do in life. She was, I think, the first girl in her family to start working.
Okay.
You know, to do a PhD.
Right.
And she's done it all by herself. You know, even her parents were not very, very up for it. They felt like, my nana nani felt that, kya karna hai itna padke.
I had to fight for
She had to fight for her rights. Right.
So you did a PhD in?
Physics.
Physics.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. And also I feel, you know, the whole gender bias thing, you know, I think the fact that, I mean, she has faced gender bias in general because she has a brother. I have a sister, so I've never like even seen anything like that. But I feel like there are a lot of things that, you know, her opinions have sort of transferred to me where, you know, I do treat men and women equally, which, you know, might not be the case with everybody depending upon how they've grown up. Because I feel like she's seen it in her life.
Right.
And I've seen it through her.
Right.
So I feel I get very agitated and angry when people don't treat men and women equally. And I think that somewhere comes from her to me.
What's the best advice that you've got from her?
I think, are you trying to tell me the best advice?
No.
Okay. I think, you know, when I wanted to act and I wanted to, like, my father was very, very scared of a lot of things. And that was the reason why he probably did not want to sign that contract. And he was protective.
Sure.
After that, he's been equally and maybe more excited to see me on the screen.
Right.
But she was like, you know, there's a lot that I wanted to learn. There's a lot I wanted to do. There's a lot I dreamt of. But I never got a chance to fulfill it. So if you dream of something, you should go for it. And that is the maybe the advice that has changed my life.
What is the best advice that she's given you now that she's all grown up and so successful?
Take less stress.
Yeah, chill.
Chill.
Yeah, I think we think a lot, you know, and especially parents, I feel everything has to, you know, be taken seriously and you're worried.
Right.
And I feel like sometimes you're just thinking of the possibilities of what can happen and that makes you worried.
Chill, we keep thinking about the future.
Yeah.
That when are the girls going to settle?
Yeah.
When the time is right.
Well, on that chill note, we shall end this interview. And thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
It's been lovely chatting with the both of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you guys for watching. We're going to be back soon with another lovely, exciting episode of Family Matters with your favorite stars talking about their growing up years.